morning. So today I have Sushma with us, who is a technology executive, which is all about building highly technological teams, which are all about productivity and efficiency. She has been in this field since 15 plus years, so she definitely knows the ins and outs about technology and how to make a team successful. Let's welcome Sushma on 10 Minutes of Hiring Wisdom, where she will tell us about her experience, what she has learned along the way, and how we can learn from her. Hi, Sushma. How are you doing today?
I'm good. Thanks for having me here.
Of course. So, Sushma, can you tell us about your experience and where you currently work?
I currently work as a VP and Head of Engineering at a company called ApartmentList. ApartmentList is a rental marketplace. We connect renters with properties. And I've been here for 3 years.
And how has your experience been, especially tech, how has your experience been in a position which is usually predominantly dominated by men? So how has your experience been? Because it's very inspiring to see a lot of women going into field where men were supposed to be. So it's great to see things like that happening.
Yeah, I think a lot of my journey has been like lonely, where I've been like the only woman in leadership meetings and things like that. But I think over a period of time, it has evolved. And I think more and more women are getting into leadership, which is a great thing. And I'm very passionate about encouraging more women to get into those positions as well. So at ApartmentList, now at the leadership level, we have about 50% women. Which has been awesome to see. And it's just been a growth. Like when I started, it was very different. And I think over a period of time, as an org, we've been committed to DEI as a whole.
Okay. And you mentioned that it's a 50% ratio and everything. I'd love to hear regarding the culture at your company specifically, because these days a lot of companies are finding it hard to retain employees just because employees don't feel like they're connected to the organization. They don't feel like they belong to it. So what is something so great about ApartmentList that you've stayed with the company for over 3 years now?
Yeah, it's mainly the people and the culture of the company itself. I think I believe in the statement culture add as opposed to culture fit. Every new person who joins ApartmentList has something new to add. And I think we've been able to attract talent where we are looking for people to come and add something and make us better as opposed to somebody who can come and fit into our existing setup and continue to maintain that. So that has worked out pretty well for us. And people are very vulnerable and very open and honest with each other. And I think there's a trust culture among each other. And I think there is there's no fear of conflict. People want to be open and honest and actually embrace conflicts in a positive way so that we can all move forward together as opposed to just moving forward by themselves. So that has been something that has kept me at ApartmentList.
That sounds amazing. And I loved the culture fit. You mentioned the difference between culture fit and culture add, because I think everyone has so much to add, and just making sure that differences are embraced where they can coexist with each other is something that's so important. So I love what you mentioned that. So thank you for sharing that, Sushma. So I'd love to hear, Sushma, regarding your journey. What did you major in? How did you end up in a VP tech field position? And what have you learned along the way that a lot of us could learn from, especially because the job market is so hard and saturated these days?
Yeah, I grew up in India, and I actually...
What part?
In Bangalore, south. And
okay.
As I was growing up, actually, I wanted to be a doctor. And then very soon I realized, as I started reading biology, this is not something that I actually could do pretty well. So I decided, I actually loved playing games at that time. I loved playing DOS games. So that kind of attracted me to computer science. And I did my bachelor's. I worked there for just a little under a year. And then I wanted to actually do master's. And at that time, I was very interested in AI, ML, NLP. And it was just like, I think, not beginning. I would say it was very early stage at that time. And so I came to US to study master's at the University of Texas, Dallas. And once I graduated, I wanted to continue to pursue a career in computer science. At that time, the market wasn't great. There weren't any jobs around AI or ML. And I just got into consulting and worked for e-commerce companies, banking industries and stuff. And then continued to understand that I wanted to stay in management, not just be an individual contributor. I wanted to have a larger impact. So I actually left to join a company called Kodak Gallery. which was owned by Eastman Kodak, which was into photo products. So I ended up there as a manager. And it only lasted for a year because the company went through bankruptcy. But there was a ton of lessons learned during that 1 year, which was awesome. And I continue to stay in management path. I worked for Black Hawk Network, which was in payments and gift card industry, moved to Zoosk, which was in online dating space, and then finally ended up at Apartment List. So it's just been a series of various types of management challenges along the way.
So you mentioned that Kodak went through bankruptcy, but you learned a lot of lessons. What was the biggest lesson that you learned that has stuck with you throughout till this day?
Yeah, I think the hardest part was how do you actually balance transparency? Because you want to be transparent with your employees, the people that you manage, that there's a good chance the company will go under. And balance transparency with also like motivation. How can I continue to motivate employees? Because if the company survives, you don't want them to leave. So it was like really hard being a first-time manager to really understand how to do this. And one of the biggest lessons that I myself learned because of looking at the leadership was like focus on transparency, be open and honest, and state really openly like what do you expect from the employees, and then also make sure that you're taking care of them. So I think those lessons really helped me kind of take those forward across my career as well.
To say the very least, you sound like an amazing manager. And I love the honesty aspect because I think a lot of managers tend to want to give feedback, want to be honest, but there's this professional barrier. But I feel like you're fitting both of these side by side while making sure that your employees are feel cared for, which is something that's very important. So hats off to you to maintaining that balance. My last question, Sushma, for you would be, is your company hiring? What kind of positions are open? And what are some of the top priority positions that you're actively hiring for in the market?
Yeah, we are hiring quite a bit. We are hiring for software engineers, product managers, sales folks. I'm hiring for engineering managers. So all across the board. And we actually raised a Series D last year. We turned profitable. So the company has been
tremendous
growth. So it's exciting journey so far.
That sounds wonderful. And my last question, which was building on this, is are you hiring within the US? Are you open to global hiring?
We are open to hiring all across the United States, but we are currently not open to global hiring. But anywhere in the US, we are very much open to hiring.
Okay, sounds good. Well, Sushma, thank you so much. Our time is up. I absolutely loved how your journey started from India by realizing that you wanted to become a doctor, but then realized that biology wasn't a good fit for you, got interested in games and came to the US to pursue a master's, and then went through different companies, learned a lot of lessons. It's definitely inspiring to see women like you are paving their way out there for women who want inspiration, and you're definitely inspiration for me. So thank you for coming on the show and sharing about your lovely journey. It was an absolute pleasure.
Awesome. Thank you so much. I enjoyed our conversation.